In this video, we'll show you how to define database table actions, filter XML data, and map this data to a database. Our source component is an XML file with a schema definition. Let's add our source component to the mapping. Our target component is a database with three tables. The authors and books tables have a foreign key relationship. The third table has only one column that will contain information about when the mapping was last executed. It is important to know that there is auto increment set for the primary keys in the authors and books tables. This means that new IDs will be assigned automatically by the database. Now let's insert our database. We need only authors and books. We don't need the check-in info table in this component because we won't map anything to this table. First of all, let's map the author's details. Let's also connect the name element with the author column. Next, we need to map the publication data to the books table. Then we will map information about print length. Since auto increment is set for the primary keys in both of our tables, we don't need to map any IDs from the source file. Let's take a look at the output. As soon as we map the source data to the database, two buttons appear in the database component. These buttons enable you to define table actions. Let's click the first button. In the upper part of the dialog, you can set up actions that will be performed before any actions defined for each record. You can choose to do nothing at all at this stage. You can also delete all the records from your database. Finally, you can type a custom SQL statement. You can also define actions for each record. For example, you can insert all records. Alternatively, you can decide when to update, delete, or ignore records. All input data will be compared to the database data. If all the comparisons are true, a specific action will be performed. This dialog box also allows you to define when to roll back your data when an error occurs. Besides, you can define tracing and error logging settings, as well as bulk transfer settings. We will show you some of the possible scenarios of using table actions. In the first scenario, we want to delete all the records from our database and then populate the database with all the data from the source file. To achieve these goals, we will configure the delete statement first, then we will set the insert all action on the authors and books tables. Let's start with the actions for the authors table. First of all, we will delete all the data from the database, including all the data from the child table. Let's also check actions for each record. Author IDs will be generated by the database, and we will receive all the other records from the source file. Now let's take a look at the actions for the books table. We have the same insert all action for all records. Book IDs will be generated by the database. The author ID column references the primary key in the authors table, so author IDs will be supplied automatically. And we will get all the other records from the source file. Let's see the output. We can see that the data from the database is deleted first, and then new records are inserted into our database. The SQL statements you see in the output are for preview purposes only. If you want to actually execute the statements, click Run SQL Script. After running the SQL script, we can see all the source data in our database. In real-life situations, the database is constantly changing, and several people may be working on the same database. That's why deleting all the database records is not the best option. In this scenario, our goal is to update authors and books with data from the source file. We also want to track the date and time of the mapping. To achieve the goals, we will update authors and books that exist both in the source file and the database. The updative condition will prevent us from getting duplicate records in our database. We also want to insert author and book records that exist only in the source file. Besides, we will add an SQL statement to get information about the date and time of the mapping. Let's start with the table actions for the authors table. First of all, we will switch to none. Then we need to add a new action. We will set the updated condition on the author column. The authors in the source will be compared to those in the database. If there are the same authors, only these authors' records will be updated in our database. The authors that exist only in the source file will simply be inserted into the database. We will set similar conditions on the books table. First of all, let's insert a new action. Then we will set the updated condition on the title column. If the same books exist in both the source and the target, only these book records will be updated in our database. The books that exist only in the source file will simply be inserted into the database. Let's check the output. Actually, there's another thing we would like to add to the table actions. Let's set the following SQL statement. Our statement inserts the current daytime value into the tracking info table. This way we can easily check when the mapping was last executed. Let's see the output. After running the SQL script, we have the following data in our tables. For example, we can see that some of our authors have several new book records. Before the mapping, there were a couple of authors and their books that existed only in the database and not in the source. These records remain unchanged in the database. Thanks to the insert rest action, our database has received several new authors and their books from the source file. Besides, we can see when the mapping was last executed. In the third scenario, our goal is to update authors and books only with the fantasy genre records. Let's first filter the authors and map only those whose books belong to the fantasy genre. To insert a filter, right-click the connection between the author and authors nodes. Then select Insert Filter from the context menu. The first parameter is already connected. The second parameter of the filter accepts a Boolean value. We will add the equal function whose result will be supplied to the Boolean parameter of the filter. Let's connect the genre node with the first parameter of the equal function. For the second parameter, we will need a constant. Type fantasy in the text bar. Connect the constant with the second parameter of the equal function. Finally, connect the result of the function with the Boolean parameter of the filter. The equal function will compare the genre values of each author with the value of the constant. If at least one book of an author belongs to the fantasy genre, the author's details and all their books will be inserted into the target. Let's see the output. One of our authors has books of different genres, and now we've got all of these books in the output. Now we also need to filter our books so that only the fantasy books will be mapped. Let's add another filter on the connection between the publication and books nodes. All that is left to do is connect the result of the equal function to the Boolean parameter of the new filter. Let's check the output. As you can see, only the fantasy books are now in the output. You can test all the MapForce features yourself. Simply download a fully featured 30-day free trial from the Altavo website.